Author Zora Neale Hurston is perhaps best known for her novel, Their Eyes Are Watching God. And author Margaret Mitchell is best known for her novel, Gone with the Wind, two women whose writings shined a light on different periods of American history.
And their works are still widely read, of course, and have led to conversations throughout the decades. And now One Mid-South Theater Group is pairing that legacy with a look at both the worlds Mitchell and Hurston wrote about. Here to explain how you can join the discussion. Good to have you guys. Stephanie Shine, you are director of this production with Tennessee Shakespeare Company.
Yes, that's right.
And Anne Perry Wallace, you play Hurston, essentially.
Yes.
First of all, it's a salon, which means that it sounds like it's a play, certainly, but it's more comfortable, casual. There will be opportunity for conversation, or?
Absolutely. And what we've done is taken of excerpts from both of those seminal novels.
Right. Mm-hmm. Readings.
Right. And we are reading them with a cast of six women, so it's all females reading, all of the voices, and we are exploring the similarities, if there are similarities, mm-hmm. between the situations that the main characters in these novels go through. So we're looking to see if Janie experiences some of the things that are similar to Scarlett, and how these two characters
from different worlds,
totally. different time periods.
Right.
But the feminine experience mm-hmm. of it is similar.
So, right. Why is it so important to have this conversation and have these different voices, maybe in some cases, to be at the table?
I think that what we're exploring is where women, in this case when they were girls, had these realizations, and that their lives took on different meaning. For Zora Hurston, mm-hmm. when she was about between 9 and 10, her mother died, and she left this all-black town. She really had no experience of living outside of a black town, so her identity was formed without race, but she leaves and all of a sudden she realizes, I'm a black girl.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I look different mm-hmm. from some of my neighbors.
Yes, and so I think in Margaret Mitchell's case, right. she was 10?
She was 19. 19. When her mother died. She lost her mother early as mm-hmm. well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's a similar experience. But what right. was her experience after her mother's death?
Well, I think one of the pivotal things is that she was. A lot of time had gone by before she realized that the South had lost the war.
She didn't know that the South didn't win until she was about 10. So they both had interesting realizations, but yeah. that were formed after their childhood experiences because of many stories that they heard mm-hmm. and their own experiences, and it really shadowed their whole lives mm-hmm. in a beautiful
way. How's
this
changing you, or has it changed you with your own interpretation of those writings?
Well, I am here to admit with some shame that I was new to the writings of Zora Neale Hurston, and I am so thankful that I've discovered her now.
Yeah.
She just was not on my radar when I was in high school, but I'm so glad she is on our children's radars.
I felt the same way because Gone with the Wind, when I was a teenager, I read it 13 times.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. And yet never heard of Hurston, so I went online and I was astonished at that, and that should tell us something.
But yeah. There's a reason why we didn't know about her.
There is. So Zora Hurston was very popular during the Harlem Renaissance, mm. and most of her books were published after that. But at the time of her death, her books were out of print.
Wow.
And so around 1975, Alice Walker, who loved Zora Hurston, went on this search to find her unmarked grave and put a tombstone
what?
On it.
The author of The Color Purple?
Yes. Yes. And so she found it and put a tombstone, and then she began to write about her, and then the resurgence happened.
Wow.
So that's fairly new for some people, so she's now required reading.
And well, she should be.
Yes,
and we're
should
so
be,
thankful
for sure.
Alice.
She should
right.
be.
Right.
Yes, thank you.
Awesome. Well, you just got to go, because this is a conversation that needs to happen
so
often.
Because, you've had so much debate
experience.
Over the years about Gone with the Wind, whether
that's
or not
right.
it
that's
romanticizes
right.
slavery.
That's right.
So a lot of perspectives there.
There
Ladies,
are many.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much for sharing yours.
Thanks for
we
having
do appreciate
us.
It.
Thank you.